So I'm leading to the fact that the classes were still white, generally white. For me, it meant nothing because I taught in Canada. It meant nothing. But to them, these poor children, the only black person probably they have seen closely had put them in their bag or had fed them as a maid. Now, to have this little woman teaching them was very difficult. So I'm trying to excuse their behavior, which I'm about to say a little bit later. So for the first few lectures, three actually, they would come in, about 15 minutes, lectures take 45 minutes. About 15 minutes into the lecture, they would walk out. Not all, but they were this tall, I mean, I'm sure they played rugby. Tall guys who would just literally, they place themselves in a position where, if you know our lecture theater, if you're in the middle and many people are going to walk out at the same time, the whole class had to stand up to allow them to walk out. They would walk out. They did that once, twice. That time, I just got a friend and I said to this friend, stay at the door with the camera and let's take photos of these people who are getting out and sort them out at a bit later stage. So that fourth lecture I went in, I said, okay, you guys have been walking out in the middle of the lecture. I don't know what your reasons are, but you don't do that. You don't walk out. It's rude to walk out of a lecture. If you have a problem about who I am teaching you, get used to it. I'll teach you. I'll teach your aunts. I'll teach your grandchildren. I'll teach everybody. If this is the first time you see a black woman who can speak chemistry, get used to it. This is the world. It's coming. Maybe the only black person you've seen is the one who put in your bag, but the world is coming. And if I see you getting out again and I get your photo, I will fight until you're expelled from this university for bad behavior. Shh. From then on, I haven't had a problem. We live happily ever after. The top administrators, fine. I could deal with them. They were nice. They were friendly. They supported me. If I asked for money, they would give money. They really wanted me to grow. The middleman was dangerous, completely dangerous. I could not adjust to the fact that I work with people in the chemistry department. If I walk out on the street, they walk past me as though I don't exist. You meet somewhere else in shops or something, everybody pretended you are not there. It's air. They look way past you. But I had to tell them in the department that you don't do that to me. I couldn't deal with it, that the people you work with pretend you don't exist outside that particular room. So to me, that was a big cultural shock. I couldn't deal with it, really. I still cannot deal with it. And you do that to me one, two times, three times, I'll just pass you. I'll never bother with you. It was tough, but it was a challenge. Because I just felt, okay, I could have left Rhodes because I think places like Wits were getting better because they are bigger. I could have moved very easily, really, with my capabilities in research. But I just felt, why run away from a problem? I've run away from one in Lesotho. Now I run away from another. I cannot be a runner all the time running away. I've got to solve the problem for myself and solve it for others. Be a role model for others. There will be women, there will be Africans who will come in here. If we keep running, how it's not solving the problem. I just felt we had to do the best we can. I really just decided I am going to work. If they had been friendly with me, I wouldn't have been who I am today because I would have relaxed. I work.